Good afternoon, friends. Let's see about the next point. The next point is digestive glands and the digestion process. The total digestive glands present are basically three, majorly salivary glands. These three salivary glands are submaxillary gland, sublingual gland, parotid gland. The major salivary gland is parotid gland out of these three. Along with this, two other organs are also involved in the digestion process, that is liver and pancreas. So let's see about parotid, sublingual and submaxillary gland. From these three glands, saliva is secreted and mixed up with the food, and with the help of tongue and teeth, the food is chewed and converted into the bolus when it enters the oral cavity and into the pharynx. These three other organs such as stomach, liver and pancreas are also involved in this digestion process. The major new organ in this is the liver. Liver is bilobed. It has two lobes. It consists of hepatic lobules, which are the structural and functional unit of liver. These are made up of hepatic cells. Hepatic cells are arranged in these hepatic lobules in the form of cords. These hepatic cells arranged in the form of cords are surrounded by a thin layer of loose connective tissue. That tissue is known as Glissoni's capsule. In these hepatic cells are present. These secrete the bile into the thin muscular sac present inside the large lobe of the liver. That thin large sac of muscle is known as gallbladder, where the bile is secreted by hepatic cells of the liver inside the sac. Other side of the lobe is having hepatic ducts. These two combine with gallbladder duct and form a common duct. Along with these, pancreas also secrete pancreatic juice along with hormones such as insulin and glucagon. These enters into the duodenum part of the small intestine with the help of a controlling muscle that is known as sphincter of Oddi, a specialized sphincter. Then, due to the activity of pancreatic juice and the enzymes present, the further digestion